Welcome back. We love our pets, and we know that you folks at home do as well. And that's why we're digging deep into the bag of pet food today to see what we're actually feeding our furry friends. Eyewitness News reporter Haley Bianco joins us in the studio with what she's learned about pet food in this special report. Haley?
Nick, as a pet owner myself, when I go to the pet store, it can be confusing. There are a lot of options, and there is a lot of conflicting information out there. That's why I reached out to the experts to figure out what the ingredients listed on the labels really mean.
The bag is empty. It's time to go to the store, where there are too many options to count. Labels like grain-free, GMO-free, holistic, all of which vary in nutrition and price, which a lot of times pet owners are willing to pay if they're convinced it's the best.
The price doesn't matter.
Well, right now it's the only kid we have. I don't mind spending it to get the quality of it.
But is it really worth the extra bucks?
I think people get really hung up in a lot of, you know, kind of the pet food fake news and kind of miss the forest for the trees.
Dr. Kaylin Hines is a board-certified veterinary nutritionist. She and local pet experts helped me debunk some of that misinformation. Let's start with that hot trend of grain-free pet food.
It's a marketing scam. It actually means nothing.
These experts explained to me that grain-free does not mean the food is free of carbohydrates. All it means is the company took grains out and replaced them with something else, like potatoes or lentils. Now, some pet professionals will argue that grain-free is a benefit for animals with allergies, and they're not wrong. But these experts say most likely your pet isn't going to be allergic to all grains. Which brings me to my next myth. Do we need to keep our pets away from corn?
Corn is one of the ingredients that's often vilified, but you don't want to look at individual ingredients. You want to look at the nutritional profile of the whole diet.
So corn's okay, but Hines says the order of ingredients on the labels is what truly matters. Dr. John Broskovich at Mountain Shadow Veterinary Hospital in Schuylkillhaven tells me he wants to see meat among the first three ingredients in pet food, not meat byproduct. The real deal.
The more protein and the more food, the more meat they have, the better.
Patty Lance owns Sasha's Canine Bakery near Pottsville. She's very selective in what she puts on her shelves. Meat is the first ingredient in all the food varieties she offers. She stocks her shelves with food made in the U.S. by family-owned companies and stays away from preservatives like BHA and BHT. Janice Coles practices a similar sales approach in Lehighton. Coles carries just 5 brands on her shelves. She avoids ingredients from China and also fillers and artificial coloring.
When you have the wrong food, 5 minutes later or 10 minutes later when they eat, that dog or kitty cat might be going right back to the bathroom because it's just going right through them.
It's all about the balancing and the absorbability of the nutrients.
It's not just knowing how to read a label. Your pet's health could be at stake.
You're a good girl.
Poor quality coat, when you don't have a proper balance and good nutrition, you're going to see poor muscle tone.
So many pet owners are turning to alternative options, home cooking their pet food. It's popular, but also has risks.
I've seen pets that have developed fractures of their bones because they don't have enough calcium. I've seen dogs and cats develop severe heart disease because they didn't have enough taurine, which is a amino acid derivative in their diet.
If you're cooking food for your pet, experts say it's likely you'll miss some of those crucial minerals and vitamins your pet needs. Experts like Dr. Hines help pet owners come up with customized diets. But if you're sticking to the bag or the can, remember that even the cheapest food is required by law to meet specific minimum nutritional requirements. Seals like AAFCO, the Association of American Feed Control Officials, can give you some peace of mind that those minimums are being met. And one final tip. Vets recommend you choose a pet food provider which uses its own facility to manufacture the food.
I just want the best for her.
Now, there isn't one easy answer as to what food is the best. It really depends on the individual pet, so do some research. And if you do make a food switch, remember what vets say. Do it over a week, mixing the new and old foods together to avoid digestive problems. Live in the studio, Haley Bianco, Eyewitness News.
Interesting. And Haley, I think we saw your dog making his TV debut in there as well, right? Very cute. Well, it's a lot of information to absorb. If you want to get the details and how these ingredients all play out, just go to pahomepage.com. There's much more there.